Now, as you can all imagine, graduation occupies a very special place in the academic calendar. It is a very proud moment for all of us. It is all about celebrating your achievements. However, before we are doing so, you have to sit through a minute of reflection by me. Last year, I mentioned that we are living in challenging times. This somehow implies a transitory character. Challenges can be met, can be successfully managed, and then life returns to normal or even better than before. However, a year has passed and the crises have stayed. And with ever more certainty, we realize that nothing is going to stay the same. A horrible war still raging just a few hundred kilometers to the east, rising tensions around the globe, starvation has returned on a big scale, inflation, and is one of the biggest threats to humanity, the climate crisis. All those crises are no longer a far way away. They are real. They affect all our lives directly. This is a time where prudence, humility, tolerance, and critical thinking are required from all of us. Instead, once again, it seems that human folly is on a rampage. Did we help you preparing for such a world, of which you will be much longer part than we will? Did we teach you the skills to achieve your objectives in a world that seems to be spinning much faster than it did yesterday? Did we equip you with what it takes to lead a fulfilled life? Our hope is that your resounding answer is yes. Your last years were determined by the academic calendar, by deadlines, by midterms, by final exams, by papers you had to hand in, by presentations you had to prepare, and much more. Our last years were determined by convincing you about the merit of reading books and articles, and at the same time teaching you not to believe everything that's written. We tried to convince you to trust your own judgment, as long as it is based on empirical knowledge, to compare and discuss with your peers, to sharpen your minds and enlarge your horizon by being part of a community of scholars. In addition, to marvel at the world's diversity and see this diversity as a source of innovation. Finally, and importantly, there's one virtue you must never underestimate, and that's curiosity. If there's one small request I can make on behalf of all of us, it would be the following one. Stay curious and never stop asking questions. Graduation is, of course, also an opportunity for us to say thanks. First, it is up to us, faculty and staff, to thank you, students, that you allowed us to accompany you on parts of your way, a way that will lead you, we are convinced, to a fulfilled and happy life. Secondly, I want to thank faculty and staff who went out of their way to support you, to make your time at Webster not only a time of intensive studying, but also a time where you forged bonds and friendships that will last for a very long time. Last but not least, let us together thank families and friends who supported our joint adventure and made this proud moment possible for us. Please join me for a short applause. Now, last year I ended my speech with a quote from someone called Miley Cyrus. And as always, this is an opportunity for me to prove my intimate knowledge with youth culture. In other words, a big thank you to all of those who assisted me in finding a quote. And this time it's a quote from the song, Sweet Creature, by Harry Edward Styles. And as always, I wish that I could sing it for you, but I can't. So the quote is, we don't know where we are going, but we know where we belong. Congratulations to all of you, and may the force be with you.